Hey guys, let's think about how we can reframe the way we hunt for our profitable trades. Stick around. Hey traders, warm welcome to you. Thank you for joining me. All right, so this is a bit of a different video. What I want to think about and talk about and share with you is, how about if we reframe the way that we look for trades? So if you think about, I'm always rethinking about the way I look at the markets, the way I look at my trades, how can I eke out more edge, how can I improve my profitability, my consistency, all those kind of things. And one thing that has worked quite well for me and something that I'm going to build on over the next few quarters is the way that I look for a trade. And so let me give you an example. So the majority of people, and I'll put myself in that category as well to a certain degree, they look for the next good trade. So the objective in the mind is, I want to look for a good trade. And that could be hopefully a profitable trade, but if it's not, one where you can structure the trade nicely, you can frame the target, you can have the entry, you can have the stop, it's got a good risk reward ratio, it's got all those things that you need to make a good trade. And that's what we look for. Okay, I'm gonna look for a good trade, here we go. Oh, that's going up, you know, we'll do this, do that. And that's fine. But how about if we reframed that and made life a little bit easier for us? And again, I'm a big fan, guys, if you followed the channel for a while, of bringing our focus so that it's very narrow so we can be ultra, ultra effective. Just think about the sun. The sun, super powerful. As soon as you get a magnifying glass on it, then you start seeing the true power of it. So good trade is what we're looking for. Now, how about if we reframed the way we're looking for something else? So an example would be, if we had the market sitting there and we were bullish, let's say we're looking for some kind of bullish setup, how about instead of looking for a good trade, we just said to ourselves, I want to find the swing low. If I'm intraday trading, I'm looking for the intraday low. If I'm swing trading, I'm looking for the weekly low, monthly low. Now, to many people, that sounds scary. It's like, oh, how can I find the low? I can't find the low. Hey, you know, this is, you know, we're just trying to get what we can here. But just take a step back for a second, suspend beliefs for a moment, and just think about what you'd actually need to do to get that. It's not as far-fetched as it seems. If you're saying, hey, I want to try and time the low or find a good place for the low on this market. Now, first of all, you might go back and you might look at patterns. Hey, do we normally have a low before 3 o'clock? Do we normally have a low on a Tuesday? Is it normally the second week of the month? You know, starting to see the patterns based on what we're looking for the low in. Okay, now we're starting to frame our trade a little bit out. It turns out that Tuesday's the weakest day, all right? So when do we kind of get these lows? Well, we often get, if it's a trend day to the downside, we often get a second test in the afternoon, for example, right? So now you're adding data. All of a sudden now, you've got a day, potentially, a time frame that you're looking for, and then you start to add your patterns, which may be what your good trade is. You might say, okay, well, a fake out to the low side, or a higher low, or a double bottom, whatever that reversal may be for you, now you have a framework and you've flipped the way that you're looking for the market. And so now you are laser focused on looking for the intraday low or the weekly low if you're swing trading. That changes the game completely, because instead of going, I'm looking for a good trade in this, I think it's going higher, let me find a trade, all of a sudden you're saying, I am only looking for a market that's moving down and is going to stop moving down. And yes, I recognize that for newer traders, that seems like such an unusual thing to be doing. But when you've been trading for a while and you've got some strategies that work, now you've really narrowed what your focus is on. You don't care about things that are ripping to the upside and that flagging and stuff. And that's fine. I'm not saying discard those completely. I'm definitely not saying that we shouldn't use those, because there's a super, super powerful strategies when used. But I'm just saying, for some categories of our trading, why don't we flip it on its head and look for something specific? You'll be amazed at how different the way that you view the market, because you don't care if the market's sitting around and doing this. You don't care. You're like, well, that's not the low. The low might have been there, and if that was the low, that's fine. You're saying, okay, well, I think maybe the low is going to come in this kind of window here based on history, and it might not be too low because we're quite strong. So maybe, and we're not looking kind of really deep depths of the market, we're looking maybe a little kiss to the low, maybe a little kiss under the prior day's low, that kind of thing. And then you start to become more focused. You're like, okay, well, here we go, we're coming down, we're retesting, we're bouncing. Now, I'm not saying you're gonna get the low to the tick, I'm definitely not saying that, of course, but if you can then say, right, that looks to me like that could be the low of the day, that also looks to me like that could be the low of the week, based on things, and guess we are making an estimate, we're guessing, of course we are, but you might then say, okay, now this is matching my criteria, I've waited for this, I'm buying it here, I'm putting a stop here, and I'm going to treat it. This is the other little beautiful thing of this, guys, is that because you've reframed it as the low of the day, if you believe you've got the low of the day or close to the low of the day, why would you close it and scalp it out for a little bit? If you thought it was the low of the week, then you're going to hold that for the fruition of the trade. Now, of course, if it stops you out, still got to manage the risk. But it ends up, because you're framing it differently, if I'm looking for X, then when you think you've got hold of X, rather than thinking I've got a good trade here, where do I come out? All of a sudden you've moved into this camp, which is I've got the low of the day here, or the low of the week, or a good chance of it being, I will sit with it until the end of the day, or the end of the week, or the end of the month, whatever you're looking for. Just that reframe really kind of helps you look at the market in a different way. And yes, you may well miss these opportunities. Yes, of course. And I'm not saying discard all the other stuff where you're buying at highs, because momentum type trades are very, very profitable when executed right under the right conditions. But if you are looking for a good trade and you are looking for something specific in a market, you're bullish, say, then why not, instead of saying, hey, I want to look for, and it's range bound, or it's not very, very aggressive movement, then why don't you say, I'm going to look for the low, and give yourself that challenge, and then try to work out, like a detective, what you'd need to see for that, when it's most likely to occur, what have been the kind of attributes of prior lows that you're looking for, what are the kind of moves we get, what are the kind of time of day, day of week, all these kind of things, and then you become much more focused, and just a little different frame of mind, just changes the way you look at markets. Now, listen, it might not work for you, you might be like, oh, it doesn't really work and stuff, but I often think that when we kind of bring our focus in and we're looking for that one specific thing only, we end up looking for all the clues that will add to that or take away from it. So kind of boost the chances or reduce the chances, rather than saying it's a good trade and we're conflicting, numbers go low, it might be a short, might be a long, might be this, might be that. Is this the low of the day? Probably not, because we've probably got another 30 minutes before the flush, or we've probably got this and that. And you start to think things through a little bit cleaner. All right, guys, let me know, get on with that. It might work for you, it might not. Reframing the way that you approach the day or the week or the month, if you're swing trading, and reframing that trade idea. Take care. Bye-bye.